even though, if you think about it, if you really sit down and think about it, even though the banks are offering lower interest rates and historically lower interest rates, you do also have to consider that if you're purchasing a home, most likely you're purchasing it at a 30% plus increase. So yeah, sure, you're saving in the interest rate, but you're buying a home that typically would be 30 plus percent cheaper than what you would typically get it at. So hello, Mayday family. And for those of you that are new to my channel, my name is Mayday and I'm a licensed counselor with a YouTube channel. It is insane. So I reside in Texas. I live in Texas and I have been looking into the housing market, especially because I'm wanting to purchase property. Well, here recently, it's been absolutely insane. As I'm sure most of you know, the housing market is going crazy. No one really knows what's happening with the housing market right now. Everyone is kind of like super confused, and so am I. But let's go ahead and break down some things that are currently going on and contributing to the mess that we're currently seeing within the housing market. So one of the first things is that home prices have gone up exponentially. They have risen by 20 to 30% in some cases. And that is an incredible amount of growth as far as home prices go. So home prices have increased exponentially just within the last few months. It's been kind of working towards that way, especially since the pandemic. But within the past month to 3 months or so, home prices have really skyrocketed. Depending on the location that you live in, you're seeing as much of a 30% increase in home prices, which is nuts. Here in Texas, homes that I would have been able to purchase, for example, in 2019 for around $330,000 now are costing well over $350,000, $360,000 for the same home, for the same space, and everything else, right? Now, I did go house hunting in 2019, so I'm fortunate enough to be able to kind of have that comparison, because for 3 or 4 months, I was house hunting because I was thinking that I was gonna get a house at that point. What I ended up doing is I ended up going for my PhD instead and kind of tabling that till now, and now here we are. I kind of wish I would have just went ahead and gotten the house back then so I wouldn't have to be muddled in this mess, right? I've done quite a bit of research on this, watched quite a bit of videos, and the one consistent that I found through all of the information that I've seen and all the people that I've listened to speak on this issue is that everyone has a different opinion as to what is going on. But there is certain information that seems to be pretty consistent and seems to be pretty reliable. However, as far as the reason behind why this is happening and what is to come in the future, everyone has their own opinion. At this point, the truth is no one really kind of knows. We're all just speculating based on what is happening now. So one of the first things and the first reasons that this is happening, of course, is due to inflation, meaning the value of the dollar isn't worth what it used to be, especially after the COVID. So the value of the dollar is reducing. And so that also is affecting everything around us. I eat salmon a lot, for example. So I go to the store and I buy some salmon. As of a couple of months ago, the price of salmon has increased by about $3 at Kroger. Kroger, I'm not trying to put you out there, but it's just an example. Everything is increasing, milk, juice. And so of course the housing market is just the biggest factor in that, because the housing market has always been this huge sector, especially for the US. So when it increases, everyone notices, right? Another aspect that we're currently seeing is the incredibly low interest rates that banks are currently offering. Incredibly, historically low interest rates on home loans. So that's a huge aspect to also take into consideration. And I say that because I am one of those people that believes that this whole housing market is something that the government is directly controlling. I do believe that it's not happening organically. If there are certain things that are happening organically, it's because the government and the rich people here in the US have all pulled together to fabricate that outcome. And so one of those things that they control is, of course, the interest rates on housing loans. One has to sit back and wonder and think about, well, why is that? Why now, out of all times, is it that the government now decides and the banks now decide that now is the time to offer historically low interest rates on homes, especially when the prices have gone exponentially up? In my opinion, they are fabricating it. Government is spending on a lot of things that we don't see on the news every day, that isn't covered on TV or on the radio. You know, the less popular subjects that people tend to not pay as much attention to, that's really where all the cash is going. They're controlling the housing market, which is basically the biggest market and in a lot of cases the biggest purchase that individuals make in their lifetime, and they're kind of controlling and manipulating that because it's the easiest way to control cash flow through the economy. And it's really, really hard to find a home right now. Right now, if you want to find a home, if you want to buy a home, you're going to have to be willing to pay those high prices. They're looking to have more people start renting and less people owning homes. Now, I'm sure you've also heard about the shortage in home building materials. I personally do not believe that that is true, although I believe that there is probably some level of shortage in home building materials. I do not believe that there is enough of a shortage in home building materials to create the catastrophic mess that is the house market right now. I don't think that that single-handedly is able to distraught the whole housing market in the way that it is. I don't think that the shortage is that bad, essentially. I think that the media has been propelling this and pushing this to kind of give people reasons, because people, human beings, are always looking for answers and explanations to things. And so this is just the path of least resistance that they chose in order to kind of pin this on something, right? But I don't think there's enough of a significant shortage in materials to cause the large impact within the housing market that we're seeing today. Another important thing to consider is that the household income has not increased. Even though the price on everything is going up, the average household income has not increased. Most people are still making either the same amount that they were making before or less. So this is gonna really, really, really affect a lot of people in not the best ways, right? Especially because when you take all of those elements and combine them together, so inflation, meaning the value of the dollar is not extending as far. So in order to purchase the same amount of goods that you would have been able to more easily afford a few months ago or last year, you're having to shell out more cash to do so because the value of the US dollar is less, right? So taking that into consideration, in addition to the fact that most Americans and households are not seeing an increase in their pay, right? So they are either making the same amount that they were before or less, especially due to the pandemic. That's going to be a serious issue, right? We're going to see a lot of not so amicable consequences coming from this combination. And then on top of that, the house prices are going up. So in the US, for example, it's always been the dream of home ownership. That's what society has propelled here. And that is the way that traditionally, you know, the banks, the news, and things like that have decided to go as far as teaching people to aspire towards that particular goal and that particular dream. I will make another video because that's a whole different topic on its own, because it affects the economy in a different way. If more people rent as opposed to, you know, buying homes and home ownership and then paying them off and not paying as much in interest and things like that. So it just affects, it's different, right? Which is why I wouldn't be surprised if one of the intents was to shift more towards that, because there are economies that are currently already doing that and it works great for them. It's just not in the US. The US is just traditionally not done it in that way. It's going to be that much harder to reach that goal of home ownership, because you're not only having to put more down, you're also put more down when you buy the home, but you're also having to purchase the home at a much higher price. So the last thought here is as far as what this might look like in the future. From everything that I've been reading and studying and researching, it seems to me that in the future, the house prices are probably not going to get any lower. From what I would predict for the future is in the next coming months, well into next year, the housing market hopefully will stabilize. However, it's going to stabilize at a higher price, a higher rate. And that goes into all of the reasons that I've listed in this video: inflation, the money of the value of the dollar not extending as far as it used to, household income not increasing, but actually decreasing or remaining the same, and also the overall goal that these banks, the government, and the rich have as far as the economy goes. And of course, when they put together these goals, it is mainly for their benefit. So just keep that in mind. And so I don't think that they will allow the house prices within the housing market to go down. I actually think that, sure, it will stabilize, because what comes up, I was going to say what comes up must go down, but sure, it will stabilize and it actually might come down a tiny little bit, but nothing significant, right? It's still going to be a lot higher than where it was before. And so at some point, I think it will stabilize a little bit more, but I think that's as far as it's going to get. Right now is a crazy time. I wouldn't advise anyone to buy a home at this point in time, because it's just, I mean, even with the lower interest rate, you end up paying more for the house in comparison, and you're probably not going to really even get the house that you want, right? With everything that you want in it. And you know, once you get that house, you're stuck in it. That's it. You know, you're kind of stuck in that loan and whatever else, unless you want to sell it. And then you have to think about, if you sell it, what is the housing market going to look like then? Are you going to be able to get the value out of the house that you would need? Right? So you have to think about that, because the housing market right now is not stable. It's all over the place. So it's hard to foresee what that would look like on your purchase if you were to want to liquidate that asset at some point in the future. The only way that this works to my benefit, the way that I would want it to, is if I get the home at the price that I want, at the low price that I want, as well as the interest rate. So both those things. But of course, you know, banks, the government, the rich will probably make that very, very hard for any individual to happen. Thank you guys for joining. I really, really love these type of topics, so I'll be posting more on it. And of course, like I said, I'm looking to purchase a home, so there will be more on the housing market for sure. But in the meantime, if you haven't subscribed, go ahead and subscribe. And if you like this video, if it was helpful in any way, please go ahead and hit that like button or smash that like button. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.